Good morning, students. In today's class Operative Management, we'll start with a new topic, that is, what are the various steps that are involved in choosing the right retail location. So how a retailer will determine which is the right place for him to open his retail outlet. So before starting today's class, let us just recap previous class we have studied. In the previous class we have studied the importance of the retail location. We also studied the various types of retail location sites. There are three kinds of retail location sites. First is freestanding or isolated. Second is part of a business district or unplanned retail location site. Then third comes part of a shopping center or planned location, retail location site. So again, these are divided into subcategories. So if we understand each of these types, then the first is freestanding and isolated store. In a freestanding or isolated store, the retailer opens his retail outlet in a place where it's freestanding. There are not much retail stores nearby to his outlet. The major advantages of this kind of store is because the cost of occupancy is very less, the rent is less, and parking is very easy. But the problem is that the shop should have this own pulling power, and a lot of promotional activity has to be done in order to attract people into the store. Generally, fooding, non-fooding convenience stores are open in this way, and mom and pop stores, kirana stores are some of the examples where these kind of isolated or freestanding stores are open. Now coming to the second category of type of retail location, there is part of a business district or unplanned retail location site. When we say part of a business district or unplanned location retail location site, means that this retail site, this area was not planned. This area has developed historically as a retail location area, and throughout time people have started opening shops and doing business, retail business there. So they become retail commercial hub. So with the passage of time, so they were not planned. There are three kind of this part of a business district on planned retail area retail location site. First is a central business district, that is CBD. Then comes the second is secondary business district, and third comes are the neighborhood shops or neighborhood business district. So what happens in central business district? This is the center hub of commercial activity in retail. Here the cost of occupancy is very high, and it is very easy to attract people here because a lot of visibility of the retail store is already there. So these are centrally located. If you say Connaught Place or Colaba, some of the examples of CBD. Then coming to the second type of retail location is that secondary business district. So these are mostly retail shops that are opened at major intersection points, so where people pass through. So the kind of visibility is also more in these areas. Ansal Plaza are some of the examples is an example of the secondary business district. And then comes the third kind of business district, that is neighboring business district, where depending upon the area or the neighboring area in which the retail outlet is offered, the retail outlet is open. The retailer stocks the merchandise as per the needs of the neighboring area, where the customers, what type of assortment of products the customers want. So these neighboring area retail outlets are generally opened in order to serve the people present in that particular area. So when unplanned business retail location site or unplanned area decided, retail location site is decided, it should be kept in mind that in this area there is certain advantages and disadvantages. Advantages is, since they have developed historically, there is a lot of scope people know these places, there is a lot of visibility, there is easy to attract people into the particular stores, but there is also certain problems, that is, this area may not be having proper parking facilities, and so there may be chances of shoplifting, security concerns are also there. So these are the disadvantages of the unplanned business area. Then comes planned part of a shopping center or mall or this planned business retail location site, where what happens, these locations are particularly developed with a particular theme in mind or with a particular idea that these will be further developed into retail location hubs. Again, when we say this kind of retail location site is divided into two types. First is a regional shopping center or mall, and the second is a neighboring shopping center. In the regional shopping center mall, they are decided that placed or started in a particular format, and then they have certain anchor stores and a lot of small stores that also attract the people to come into the store. And in neighboring this community or neighboring business area retail site, what happens that here people, the retail locations are opened in other areas where they try to serve the needs of the people in the particular area. Generally, stationery stores, medical shops are examples of this this kind of neighboring community center areas of retail site. So the major advantages of a this planned shopping center, mall or strip center kind of retail location is that good parking facilities are available. There is a lot of visibility, and these are the main two advantages. It is very, very easy to attract people into the store, whereas the difficulty is that there is a chances of shoplifting, the cost of occupancy is very high, the operational costs are very high. So these are certain other disadvantages associated with this planned shopping centers or malls. So in this way, we have divided the retail locations, types of retail locations, and today we'll understand, after understanding the various factors affecting the retail location site selection, and then understanding the various types of retail locations that are available for the retailer from which he or she can choose, now we'll understand what is the best way involved in choosing the right retail location. So this will be reading in the today's class. So the selection of the store site is a systematic process which would start with the retailer first addressing the question on where to locate the retail store or the reason he wants to locate the store in. So the retailer has to decide the place or where he wants to locate the store. Depending on that, he will decide the type of retail location he is going to open. This may be a region in a city, a state or international market which he wishes to start. So this retail location can be opened in nationally or internationally. In internationally also he can open it. Nationally he can decide upon a particular city or a region or a state or a particular business district that he, or a trading area where he wants to open his shop. So this is first that he has to make up his mind. So after identifying the region, the following steps that will be, there are 6 to 7 steps, there are 7 steps of that which will be following in order to understand what the right way to choose the right retail location site. So these are the steps which we will be following to understand the types of understanding the how to choose the best retail location site for the shop. The first step is the market identification and analysis. This is the first step that the retailer has to do. The first step is in arriving at a decision on a retail location is to identify the markets attractive to a retailer. So when the retailer decides that he is going to open a retail outlet, the first thing he has to decide is that to decide upon the area, to decide upon the market that he is going to open his site, because retail location site, because he has to decide which market will be most favorable for his retail location site, retail location, retail shop or retail outlet. Because once he decides the market in which he is going to open, then he can analyze the potential market, what is the potentiality of the market, and then he can decide upon the market. Once market is decided, then he can decide the reason or a particular site in the particular market where he is going to open the retail outlet. So The first step of to arriving at a decision of a retail location is to identify the market attractive to the retailer. This is important as it needs to understand the market well, especially in a country like India, where every region has its own peculiarities. And this is also very important. Why this market identification is very important for the retailer? Because each and every India is a very diverse country, and each and every region of India has various peculiarities and various different needs. So he has to decide which market will be the best for opening the shop. Similarly, this is also important in case of international expansion. The characteristics markets of Europe are different from those of America and the Far East. Similarly, so if he wants to open his shop or retail outlet, expand his retail outlet outside internationally, the various international places are also different. The markets of Europe are far different from the America and the Far East. So we have first he has to decide upon the market, then he will come to decide what site in the market is going to open his retail outlet. So this is very important from the retailer's point of view. The company has to analyze the market in terms of the product and the industry, along with the nature of competition and the presence of competition. So while deciding or identifying or deciding the market, the retailer or the retail company has to see what product they are selling, what kind of industry they are operating in. They will understand the nature and the presence of competition in the particular market, because they have to get their people or customers from that particular market. So they must be able to get these customers from that particular market. So they have to understand the nature of competition and the presence of competition in that particular market. After analyzing all these things only, they can decide that whether to open the retail outlet in that particular market. So this is very important. Then comes the company also has to consider how old they are in the market and how many other businesses are there in the current location. So when we are analyzing the competition or the nature of the presence of competition in the market, we have to decide how old as a company, retail company we are, or whether we are a new entrant into the market. Also, we have to see how many businesses are there in the current location, the number of shops that are selling similar kind of merchandise as we are going to sell. So we have to understand also how many other businesses are there in the current location. They have to check and analyze the market and to know how far the competition has been successful in satisfying the customer. This is also important, because if a particular market is not able to satisfy the customers, the number of people visiting the market will be less. So we have to understand how far the particular in the particular location the retail businesses are able to satisfy the customers, and how many customers, potential customers, are visiting the market regularly. So in order to understand the potential of the market, and then it will be easier for the retailer to make a choice regarding the market. The company also has to analyze how convenient is the location in terms of supply chain management, warehousing, in order to make the products available on a daily basis. So while identifying the market, not only it is important whether it is visible and the profitability and the potential of the market, but we also have to decide upon the operational side of it. That means we have to see whether the supply chain management and operations can be done, whether the warehousing can be done, whether the merchandise that we are going to sell in the particular retail outlets, they will be available on a daily basis or not. So this is very important from the retailer's point of view, because if they are not having a proper supply chain, if the operational side of the managing the shop is not properly sorted out, then it will be very difficult to conduct business or continue operating the retail outlet. So it is very important from the retailer's point of view to understand the operation, supply chain and the operation side of this retailing. Now, the second step that the retailer has to do is to understand the demographics of the market. Because if we understand the demographics of the market, we'll understand the buying behavior or the consumer behavior, then it'll be easier for us to keep an assortment of products that will be attracting people to buy products from our retail shop, and also it will be helpful to attract people into the shop. The demographics of locality is essential to be considered in order to choose the retail location. So it is very highly imperative that we understand the demographics of the particular locality. The age group of the customers, the profession, lifestyle, religion, and income groups, etc., all these things has to be kept in mind. what is the age group of the customers, what kind of customers within the age group they are visiting the particular market, or what is the various people or various professions they are attending the market, because whether the professions are from the, they are doing white collar jobs or blue collar jobs. So this is very important to understand. Then the lifestyle of the people of the visiting the particular market is important to understand, because this will decide the help us in deciding the assortment that we are going to keep, assortment of merchandise that we are going to keep in the shop. The religion sentiments of, and the emotions of the people has to be also understood, and the various income groups of people visiting that particular market is also important. So in a brief, we can say these are the main factors: the age group, the profession, the lifestyle, the religion, and the income groups. These are very essential for the retailer to understand the demographics of the market. This will give an insight to the retailer about what kind of products can be sold in that particular market. The retailer needs the data of population for getting the idea of the size, quality, and buying power, and the consumer behavior of the population. So the retailer also needs the data on population. What kind of data it needs in terms of population? It needs to understand the size of population, so how big is the population, what is the quality and the buying power and the consumer behavior of the population, to understand what is the potential business that he can get from that particular market. Because once he has getting the demographics idea about the quality, about the size, about the buying power and the consumer behavior of the people in the market or visiting the market, then the retailer will be able to stock his retail outlet accordingly and can decide whether the particular market is suitable for him or whether he's having the target customers in the particular market where he can decide to open his shop. So this is also important, because after identifying the market where he's going to open the retail outlet, he has to also see the demographics of the market. So this is very important from the retailer's point of view. Understanding the features of population is integral in developing the retail marketing strategy. This is also important to utilize the data that we are getting from this population or the demographic study that can be used for developing the retail marketing strategy. Then again, it is essential to know the breakup of rural urban population, as growth of urbanization is again essential for the growth of retail. This is also gives an insight that how, whether the population, what is the breakup, how much people are rural from the rural population or how much people are urban population, and how this breakup or there is a change or there is increase in this urbanization in the particular area. Because with the growth of urbanization, then this is very important, there is a growth of retail, because people are much more willing to buy products from the retail stores. So the amount of urbanization is very important factors, one of the important factors which is included in demographics in helps him to understand the potential of the market. The retailer also needs to understand the level of literacy and the level of education in the population in order to customize the advertising campaigns and the type of merchandise he needs to store in the shop. So this is also important, because if we understand in the demographics only the kind of education and the literacy level available in the particular market, then of the customers in the particular market or the particular region or the population in the particular region, then he will able to customize the various advertising campaigns, the various media through which he will advertise, and the type of merchandise he's going to keep or store in this shop to attract people into the shop. So understanding the, after identification of the market and analyzing the market, the retailer has to understand the demographics of the market in order to tap the market well, in order to understand the potential of the market and to have a great business. Now the third step that is involved in choosing the right retail location is the characteristics of household in the area. Because it is the people or the households in that particular area, those will be frequenting or visiting the, frequently visiting the particular market is very important, because this shows the whether the area is conducive for opening the retail store. The retailer needs to have a clear understanding of the average household's income and the distribution of this income in the area. So the average household income and the distribution of the income on the particular area is very important to know for understanding, because this will give an insight about how far the people have the buying capacity and what kind of products they will be preferring to buy. If they are from a lower, if the average income, household income is very low, then they will not be interested in buying very costly products. So this gives an idea to the retailer in understanding what kind of merchandise is going to store in the retail shops. It is necessary to know that the income of the household determine the kind of retail facilities that is required by the people in the area. This is also very important because when the people, we know the characteristics of households of the people in the area or the kind of income they are having in the particular households, it will be easier for us to know the kind of facilities that they are expecting from the retail outlet. This is helps us to design the retail marketing strategy and the facilities that we are going to give to the customers. So this becomes easier for the marketer to understand this retail marketer. For example, let us give an example to make it much more clearer. In a locality which has household which has relatively low incomes or a regular baniya is bound to exist. However, high fashion apparel retail store is likely to succeed. So if the average income household is very low in a particular area, the particular market area, then we can find a regular baniya or a small shop that is present or prevalent in that area. But you cannot open a very high fashion apparel retail store there because there will be no takers of those kind of merchandise in the particular area because the household income in that particular area is very low. So this is very important for the retailer to understand the characteristics of households in the area nearby to the market area. So they will have proper insight whether what kind of merchandise or what kind of retail store that they will be open in the particular area. Now, understanding the average age profile of the population in the area is necessary as it aids in decision making. It is very important because it also helps in deciding the kind of merchandise we want to keep, the kind of advertisement we have to make in order to attract these people into the store. So the average age profile of the population is also necessary. Let us give you an example to clear your doubt. A neighborhood which has a large number of young households may be more oriented towards fast food and casual clothing. Obviously, when people of a particular area are very, very young households are there, so they will be very young, dynamic, energetic. They will be interested in more going out and having fun, having food in fast food centers, and will be much more inclined towards wearing casual clothing. So understanding the age profile of that particular household area, households in the particular area, also helps the retailer to decide what kind of retail store he's going to open and who will be the target buyers, target consumers in the particular areas. And understanding of the employment level and the type of employment indicates the kind of purchasing power and preference that the population in that locality has. Obviously, when we understand the employment levels and the type of employment that is available, we'll understand what is the buying power or the purchasing power of the consumers in that particular area and what are the preferences that the population has in that particular area. So we can, according to the preference and according to the buying power of the people, we can store the merchandise in the retail store. Now coming to the fourth step, a fourth important step involved in choosing the right retail location is the market potential evaluation. So after identification analysis, after demographics, and after understanding the characteristics of household in the area, finally we are in a position to determine the market potential. Once we understand the market, evaluate the market potential, we will be in a position to open or decide whether we are going to open our store in a particular area or not. The paying capacity of the population plays an important role in the evaluation of the potential of the market along with the level of competition and demand. So the paying capacity or the buying power of the population is a very important role in evaluation of the potential of the market along with the level of competition and demand. So if the people are having a very good buying capacity, we have not only that, we also see the level of competition. The competition level is very high and we are not able to get the attract customers into the store, we will not be able to make. Similarly, the kind of demand of the particular merchandise is there in the particular market is also important, because if the demand is not high, then the potential of the having a good business in that particular area will be diminished. So the paying capacity, the level of competition and the demand are the main factors that have helped in the market potential evaluation. It will help in understanding and checking the compatibility of the retail store. So it will give an idea to the retailer that whether his store is compatible to that particular area or not. For example, if you will let us give an example to have a clear understanding of this step, is that a good location for a gift shop would be nearer to a busy market so that potential customers can visit the store and purchase after looking at the gifts on display. So obviously when we are opening a good gift shop, in a particular area. It should be nearer to the busy market so that potential customer can actually visit the store. The visibility of the store will be more. When the visibility of the store is more, then we can keep these innovative gifts or the beautiful gifts on display, and the people can see these gifts on display, and then they will be attracted to visit the particular store in order to buy these gifts. So this is very important to understand the market, understanding the market potential of the area. Now, the retailer should also have the knowledge of regulations and laws in of the country in which the store is being operated. So we have to understand the various laws. The retailer should have the laws, knowledge of the regulations and laws available in the particular country or the particular area in which he is going to operate his retail store. Other things such as communal festivals have an impact on the demand and should also be considered by the businesses, such as Christmas. So they should also understand the various communal festivals that is available that will impact the demand. So it will, the retailer will be able to understand that during these festivals, the level of demand will be more. It may be Christmas, it may be the Dashera, or it may be any other occasions, Akshaya Tritiya. So a lot of communal festivals are there, and the retailer should be, where he's operating the store, must be having the, not only having the knowledge about the regulations and rules in the particular country or the particular region, but also understanding what are the various communal festivals available and which will impact the demand of the goods or merchandise in that particular period of communal festivals. Navratri, Christmas, Akshaya Tritiya, Dashera, there are a lot of festivals, Valentine's Day, Friendship Day. So these are all festivals or communal festivals or occasions where people, there are chances of demand spiking. So the retailer should have an idea of these communal festivals or occasions in order to understand the market, in order to evaluate the market potential of that particular area. Now coming to the fifth step is the accessibility and amenities of the market. If the particular retail area is not at all accessible, or the amenities available is not up to the mark, then it will be very difficult for the retailer to operate the store. So the retailer has to have the knowledge whether about the accessibility and amenities available in the market. It can be defined in terms of availability of public transport and road or local train connection to reach the market. This is very important. If the place is centrally located, or if it is proper public transport and it is connected by various routes and local trains, more and more people from that area and nearby areas can come to the particular market to make purchases. So this is very important to understand the accessibility of the market. Public, when we say public transport refers to the means by which we can reach the market, the frequency of bus and train connectivity to different parts of the city. Kolaba or Linking Road in Mumbai are considered as from very properly accessible. So it should be well connected, and the frequency of bus and train connectivity should also be more, so that the people can immediately come to the market, buy products and go to the nearby places. So if we say example, Kolaba and Linking Road in Mumbai are some of the examples of this retail locations which has very good accessibility or public transport. Depending upon the type of product to be retailed, facilities like free and ample parking becomes important. For example, Ansal Plaza in Delhi is preferred because of availability of ample parking space. So amenities like ample parking space is very important, because it depends upon the kind of product that we are going to retail. Because if you are going to want to open a mall or a strip center or a place where people can come visit and spend some time in order to view all the products or merchandise on display and then make a decision to buy or not, we should have free and ample parking space. This is very important. So if we say example, Ansal Plaza in Delhi is preferred because it has very availability of very free and ample parking space. So this is the accessibilities and amenities in the particular market is really important for the retailer. Then coming to the sixth step, that is very important in deciding how to open, whether to open, whether the place is right for opening the retail location, is identification of alternatives. The retailer should not always just pinpoint on a particular location, but he should always look at various similar locations, similar alternatives that is available to him where he can open the store. And after going through all the five steps which I mentioned previously, for all the various similar locations, he can identify the various alternatives and then decide what is the best alternative for him to open the particular retail store in that particular market. Most of the times it so happens that a retailer is in a hurry of starting the business and finalizes the location, which costs him a fortune. That is one of the major reasons of failure. Why the retail outlet failures? Because they many a times the retailer, they do not go for alternatives. They decide to do not evaluate various alternatives that are retail site alternatives that are available to them, and in a hurry of opening their shop in a very short span of time and to make profit, they finalize a location which is not suiting to them or not suiting to the merchandise they are going to sell, and this cost the retailer a lot of money. They are going to lose a lot of money and they will be a failure. So it is very important for the retailer so not to hurry, ponder upon the various alternatives that is available to the retailer, and then decide upon a particular retail location. Therefore, the retail should not carry on finalizing retail location and should also go out for alternatives and evaluate other locations with similar parameters. So various other locations that are similar locations that are available to the retailer has to evaluate those locations also in order to understand what are the positives and negatives in each and every location, and then decide or zero in upon a particular location that matches his requirement. Then the retailer has to select the site to locate the store based on certain points. That is, first is the traffic accessibility of the market, the total number of stores, the type of stores that are existing in the area, the amenities available to buy or to lease, the product mix to be offered by the retailer, etc. So there is various alternatives, the various sites under which the retailer can evaluate the various alternatives. First is to see the various whether the traffic accessibility in the market, how far the market is accessible, what are the total number of stores and the type of stores that exist in the particular area, whether he'll be able to compete with them or understand the nature and the presence of competition, the various amenities available like free parking space. Either he has to understand, he has to decide whether to buy or lease the particular retail location site, that it is, what is the scope of investment he's having, what is the financial status of the retailer, whether he can go to rent out a property or lease a property, or he can buy that particular retail location site, and also the product mix that is to be offered to the retailer. This can be known by understanding the demographics, the household, the average household income in the particular area. This will give an idea of what is the various product mix that is going to keep in his store in order to attract people, what is the assortment of merchandise he is going to keep in the store that will attract, and what is the visibility of the store in the particular market. So all these things has to be decided, and all these things, all the similar retail alternatives that the retailer is having, these retail alternatives should be gauged or should be gauged from these standpoints in order to understand which is the best alternative for the retailer for opening the retail store. And finally, finalize the best and the most suitable location for the retail outlet. So what happens? Once the rigorous process of selecting the location is followed and the retailer finally finalizes the most suitable location for the retail outlet, and the retail outlet is opened on the selected location. So after going through this various rigorous process of the 7-6 steps that is given previously, which we have discussed, then finally he is in a position, after understanding the alternatives, by he will choose the best alternatives that is available to him, and then he will open his retail shop in that particular market. So in today's class we have understood what are the various steps involved in choosing the right retail location. So I will be sending you the notes digitally. Please go through that. If you have any doubts, come back to me. I will be solving your own doubts, and no need to panic. And finally, thank you for your attention.